All right, so we are back where we left it, and as you can see, my little my overlay is working now after I restarted OBS, so we shouldn't have any problems there. Now let's do the audio visualizer, because we want to have like some cool music going on. The audio visualizer is really easy to do. You just have to get a plugin called Spectralizer, and I will also leave a link to that in the description that will enable an audio visualizer here. Okay, so just click on the audio visualizer, and I'm just gonna add that like this. I'm going to lower this one to 3 pixels, and the bar spacing is going to be 4 pixels. And then I'm just gonna make this a little bit smaller. I'm not really sure, it looks a little bit different from... actually, I'm going to lower this a lot. Let's do like this. So now we have an audio visualizer, and it looks like crap right now. As you can see, you can't even see it, but don't mind that. I'm going to add an image, and this is where we need to start Pretzel. Okay, so as I said in the first video, we are going to use Pretzel for the program to handle the audio visualizer. And in settings, I have set my output as a HDMI high definition audio port that I don't use. This is to separate it from the desktop audio. If we click all settings and go to file output, you can actually set your stuff here. And if you want to have it like I have, you can check here real fast. Not that this isn't really a tutorial on how to do the file outputs, but you need to set the cover image, you need to set where the song is saved and stuff like that. We're gonna get back here in a little bit. So I'm just gonna start Pretzel, and I'm going to import the image that it's saving when it's running. It's going to be what's gonna name it? Like Pretzel cover image, maybe. And I'm gonna browse to that. So do remember where you saved it. Mine is in my assets folder. So here we go. Now we get a cover. And I'm gonna click OK. We're gonna add the text, which is a text source. And I'm gonna Pretzel song name. Like so. I'm gonna select the big nodal titling font. It's a free font. We used it in the last video as well. And I'm going to do read from file and just browse to the Pretzel song name file. Now at the bottom here, I'm going to do use custom text extents, and I'm gonna set it to, I believe, 1100, and the height will be 70, like so. I'm going to move it here, and the something like this with the cover. Now we need to add the music, the kind of actual music, so I'm going to do an audio output capture, I believe, and it's going to be the Pretzel HDMI, because I put it on the HDMI source, and it's going to be the NVIDIA high definition audio. So you can see we are getting the Pretzel here. It's very high, so I'm gonna lower it down to something like here. And now if we go back into the audio visualizer, we can select an audio source, and it's going to be the Pretzel HDMI that we just made. And now it looks like this. So Something like that is probably fine. Going to group them up and name them audio visualizer group. Now we can move it into the position that we like. I think it doesn't really matter, but you shouldn't move it around later in here because it will also move around on the other scenes. So in the PC main scene, we're gonna add the, you can't hear any music by the way, I hope not, because it's actually on the OBS that I'm recording on is on the other screen. So it's not going to record any sound from this OBS. Now we're gonna do, it's gonna import a scene. It's going to be the audio visualizer scene. Where is it? Audio visualizer, it's here. And as you can see, we now have an audio visualizer. I'm gonna crop it down by holding down the Alt key. If you missed the first one. And I don't want it that big. Not, we could actually do, we can lock this, just lock everything if you want to focus on moving just one thing. So maybe like that, looks kind of cool, right? This is how it looks with the, yeah, the setup I'm usually run. So in the background here is just an image right now because running two OBS and then a game and then the Elgato at the same time is kind of heavy. So I just used an image. If you missed that, this is a fake game capture. Now let's focus on the NES Classic scene. And this could be any console, of course. It doesn't have to be the NES Classic, but in this case it is. So we are going to go... Actually, while we are still in the PC main scene and have access to the Pretzel HDMI here, we can go up to the advanced audio properties and make sure that we record the Pretzel HDMI on the first one, not on the second or the third, but on the fourth and not on 5 and 6. So you want to record it on the track 1 and 4. That is very important because otherwise you will get music mixed into your microphone and your kind of gameplay that we want to separate from everything else. But on the first track we do want it, because that's if you just upload it straight to YouTube or something, or if you stream, then I believe that it goes on the first track. So we want to make sure that everything is on the first track that we want to hear. Now we actually have everything to set up the NES Classic a little bit faster. So in the cameras, we go to the NES Classic camera here. And we import the overlay, and mine is just a square I've made in, I think, paintbrush or something. Camera, NES Classic overlay. I'm gonna browse for that here. Let's see here. I believe it's this one. Yes, it's that one here. I'm going to put it at the bottom. And I'm going to center it horizontally. And we're going to also import my my little logo. Retro Raw GIF. You can do a text or whatever you like here. This is how I have it though. Let's see here. I believe it is this one. Yes, it is. Okay. So I'm just gonna crop it like this and scale it down. Not like that. I'm gonna lock the overlay by the way, so we don't move that by mistake. It's a little bit annoying when that happens. So if you hold down control, you can move freely without snapping. I think that looks all right. Now let's lock that and import the camera, the original camera that is, so that is this one. I'm just gonna crop this down quite a bit here. And not that much. This one, I'm sitting a little bit too much in this direction here, that direction. I think you will have to do it this way. There we go. That is acceptable. I'm gonna put it on the bottom, so it's actually behind the overlay, because it works like that. The ones that are higher up are on the top. Now we're gonna import the scene that is the camera background. I'm gonna put that at the back. So going to scale it down and kind of try to get it. I think that we had like the dew there and the star next to it. Is that Rosalina? I think it's, she's called Rosalina. I think that the dew next to her were like right on the edge of the chair when I was, never mind. Let's just have it like this. This is something you should probably spend a bit of time with, but I don't feel like I have that time right now. So now we have a background in the camera. It's already looking a lot more interesting. I'm going to group this up, group selected items. I'm going to call them Camera NES Classic Group. So now if we want to just hide the camera for some reason, we can do that by just disabling the group instead of everything else. We're gonna use Touch Portal later, and this way we can just disable the camera in the NES Classic camera scene here, and then it will be hidden from all other scenes. So if you push the button hide the camera, I don't think we will make a hide camera button, but it is the same for all things pretty much. You will actually hide the camera everywhere, and you can do it with just a very simple command. So here we are in the NES Classic scene. I'm going to import the scene that is the we could do the audio visualizer to start with. I'm just gonna hide that for now. And we do another scene, which is the NES Classic, the camera NES Classic scene. So here I am. Just gonna hold down the Alt key again and crop this a bit. Put myself maybe around here. Something like that. I have another square that I'm gonna import. It's going to be the NES game overlay. And we don't have to have a specific scene for this one. Now let's go to the same directory that I was in earlier, and I believe it is this one. It's just a big square. I'm gonna put it maybe like that, because then we have a little space up here that we can use for other stuff. But it doesn't look that great when it's not symmetrical, or what you say, like OCD thing, I guess, maybe, I'm not sure. Here we now have an overlay where we will put the Elgato. So we're gonna go and actually import Elgato. So we're gonna do a NES Classic game No, we're gonna do an Elgato Game Capture scene. I believe it's on, so it should just be to add it. I'm gonna add a video capture device. It's going to be the Elgato Game Capture HD. And I'm gonna select it here. It's gonna take a little while to activate. Now in the future we are going to do a trick so that we can actually deactivate it when it's not showing, because the Elgato takes a lot of CPU performance. You can see here how it's rising. It's usually around now it's just Elgato showing and it's 15%, so it takes up a lot of performance, and that's why we kind of want to not have it active at all time, because even if the consoles are not running, the Elgato is still running. In the next classic scene, I'm going to import the scene that is the Elgato Game Capture scene. Now, as you can see, it doesn't look that great right now. One of the benefits with using it in a scene and not just putting it straight into here is that we do get a black background automatically. So I'm going to put this above the animated background. And I'm going to start by cropping some of it off. Maybe not the best game. And let's start and see if we get some background that we can go on. Yeah, you want to have a bit of space on the sides like this, because for some reason NES games are not always in the same position. They kind of change the alignment on the screen for some reason. I'm going to lock everything here except the Elgato Game Capture, so I don't know it by mistake. And almost got that perfectly. So this is good because it can actually change on the up and down direction a lot. So if we do, oh, that's almost perfect. Actually, that looks great in my opinion. Now I'm going to lock that as well. I'm going to unlock the audio visualizer and show that, and we don't want that covering the entire screen. So something like that, like that. Like that. And I guess here, this is where I usually keep mine. You don't have to have it here. Preferably you should not have it exactly like I have it. But if you want to, feel free to. Now, one of the things that I've noticed with the covers from the pretzel is that sometimes you get a little bit of a border, or some images, they kind of on the right side specifically, so let's fix that. In the audio visualizer scene, in the cover image, if we lock everything except the cover image, we can just remove like a pixel there, then we can lock it. So now it looks a little bit better here. And what time are we on? 20 minutes. We can do more. Let's do 30 minutes. We could add more scenes here, but for now let's just stick to having a PC scene and a NES Classic scene. However, we do want kind of full screen gameplay, right? It's just you kind of want at least two scenes to move between, so NES Classic full screen with camera like that, something like that. I'm gonna move that up here to the NES Classic. We are going to import the scenes we did earlier, but we don't need the animated background this time, I believe. Unless you want that. Let's do that for now and then just remove it if we don't need it. Let's see how it looks when we have imported everything. We're gonna do the, that was the Elgato Game Capture scene, and now it's the camera for the... Actually, we should do like a green screen camera scene here. So let's do a new scene again, and we're gonna do camera green screen. I think we can actually just do the original camera, but let's do it this way anyway. Gonna import the scene. No, we can't do the original camera because we're gonna add some stuff anyway, like mute icons and stuff like that. So it will not work with the original scene. And when watching videos and stuff like that, you might want to like be above how far, a little bit down. Like so, and I can see it's something like that. I'll put myself down here in the corner, maybe do like this. So if we go back to the scene that is the full screen camera, and now we can import the scene that is the, it's a lot of scenes, the camera green screen. So now I am here down in the corner playing the game, the Devil World, I believe. And I don't think we grouped that. We did. Honestly, that's in a group. We probably won't, even though it's just one thing, we're gonna add mute button and stuff, so we do want camera green screen group. We do want it in a group anyway. Just gonna lock that, make sure that everything is locked in this. Good practice to keep stuff locked so you don't move them by mistake, because it can be a pain in the ass to move them back. Now what I was thinking with the Elgato full screen here, now in the NES Classic you do have like menus and stuff. Maybe you do want to show everything, or maybe you just want to show the game and still have like a background like this. That's the wrong one. It's actually the camera. And let's lock these two so we only move on the Elgato. So I mean, maybe you do want this effect, right? Like it's in the middle of the screen, you have some stuff like a chat. Maybe we could do a chat scene later when we get to that point. We'll see where we end up. But I'm just going to go with complete full screen here. And we are going to, we can hide this, the animated background, so it doesn't take any performance. Can feel my throat giving up a little bit. How many minutes? We are at 25 minutes. What do we have to do? Yes, there is actually a couple of things that we need to do. If you're gonna capture the Elgato or any other HDMI based capture card, like an external capture card, or actually it works with anything, I can really recommend getting a HDMI switch with an audio splitter. So what that does is that it kind of splits out the audio, so you also get it on an audio cable, and I've connected that cable to my line in on my computer, so that I can hear the game without having to have a monitor with speakers and a phone jack on. That's how I sold it. I bought one at, if you're in Sweden, or then Shellon Company have a pretty good one that I'm using. It costs like $70. It's quite expensive, but it's one of the things that if you kind of go cheap on that, you can short out your PC. like I did. I bought a really cheap one, and actually it wasn't cheap. The company scammed me with a AliExpress one. And that's a story for another time though. So we're gonna do that, and I'm pretty much only using that in the NES scene. And now this is a little bit of a problem. The Elgato is a little bit high as well. This is a little bit problem that I can't have the Elgato sound separated, but it's okay. We will deal with that in the audio for the NES Classic here. I am. Do we want to do that? No. I think we are actually going down to the Elgato Game Capture. And then here I'm going to add an audio input capture. And it's going to be the HDMI switch that I have. Like that. And I believe I have that on this one. I believe it's here. Yes, I can see that I do get audio in here. This, I can't actually hear anything right now, but it does enable me to hear the game. They seem to be synchronized, so it's probably that. And the reason why I wanted to be able to hear it and not just take a monitor on this here, on the Elgato Game Capture, is because there is a delay on the Elgato Game Capture, and it's really confusing in the head when the sounds are weird. So I do want I want to have an additional one, and I'm gonna do monitor on a couple of sources here. So on the HDMI switch in, we want to go to advanced audio we can actually do that in the next scene instead, because we have everything on that scene. So if I go to the here, you can see we have a few audio sources now. We go to edit advanced audio properties. On the HDMI switch in, we want to do monitor only. So yeah, that is the game. I can clearly hear it. And we don't want to record that one on anything. So the one that I just added, that is the switch. We don't want to record that. It's going to sound horrible. And we just want to monitor it so that we hear it. And we're gonna do on the Pretzel HDMI, we're going to do monitor and output so that we can hear the music. I can hear everything right now. It's a little bit distracting. The animated background, we don't want to record that on anything at all. The cam link, mine doesn't have any audio. If you used your webcam audio, feel free to use that one instead of the microphone. But on the camera itself, we're not gonna have anything. Elgato Game Capture HD, it's going to record on the first one, not the second one. It's going to record on the third one, not the fourth, five or six. So record the Elgato on 1 and 3. Let's just make sure that everything is set up correctly here. So the HDMI switch in, nothing. The microphone on 1 and 2. Pretzel HDMI on first. And we want to record the Elgato, the microphone, and the Pretzel on the first track. And I said it earlier, but the reason for that is so that if we upload this video to YouTube, or if we stream or whatever, it's probably gonna pick the first track. So we want to have everything on that one. And now I can hear I can hear the audio, and it's very confusing. It's very distracting. So I think I can hear this audio pretty well. I'm just gonna mute the audio from these two for now. So let's do that so we still have something that. Yeah, this one has this one here is. I can have music on. Okay, I can have music on so we see something cool happening on the screen there. So that is the NES Classic, and let's continue here. This is up to you, actually. This is just the game, which is currently for me muted. We might want to have like additional stuff, but maybe not on this scene. But it is a little bit confusing that the music stopped, right? So I'm going to add the scene that is the audio visualizer again. But I'm gonna put it behind the background. So now we still have the music, but we don't see it, and we have the game in full screen. So we have two scenes here now. I think that's enough. We're gonna focus mostly on the Elgato, so since that's where most people have problems with the delays that will come soon. But we are over 30 minutes here, so this will be it for this episode, and we will I think we have set up most stuff. In the next episode we're gonna start with Touch Portal and tackle the delay issue between different consoles, and we're gonna do mute buttons and stuff like that. It's gonna be probably only Touch Portal in the next one. If you like this video, leave me a thumbs up on it, and also consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.